Come on in. That's it, take a seat. Make yourself nice and comfortable. My name is Sophie, and I'm going to be acting as your optometrist today. I believe that we've met before, haven't we? That was quite a while ago. So, are you here for your annual eye checkup today? Wonderful. Well, the eye exam is going to be relatively extensive. I'm going to be performing a few different tests with you today to check various points of your eyes. And I'll also send you through to my colleague so that she can take some photos of the back of your eye as well. Okay. She will perform the glaucoma test as well if you are over the age of 25. Okay, you just let her know when you go in there. Great. Okay, so firstly, is there anything that has changed since your last appointment? Anything that you may feel like you're a little bit concerned about? Okay, and I believe that you wear glasses, is that right? Okay, did you get a new pair last appointment? Okay, so how long has it been since you've had your last pair of glasses? Okay, so we'll definitely have a checkup of your eye, see if your prescription's changed, seeing as that has been quite a while now. So it's probably likely that today you're going to be needing some new glasses, a new prescription. But luckily for you, we are offering today 25% off any purchases of glasses. So if you'd like, you can come in later, as long as it's by the end of the day, to book your glasses appointment, and then you can have new ones sent off for you and you get that offer. Sound good? Alright, my lovely. Well, let's get started on with your eye examination. We're going to begin here with the Snellen chart behind me, okay? Alright, my lovely. So using my pen, I'm just going to point at the different letters. And if you could start first with both your eyes and just tell me what letter you read, okay? Great, keep going. Good. Okay. Okay. Good. Okay. Do we think we can try this line here? Yeah, give it a try. Okay. Okay, so we're struggling a little bit with that line there. So if we could cover this eye now first, and we'll do the same again, starting from the top, okay? I want to see how far down you can get with each eye. Okay. Good. Keep going. Okay. Good. Try that one again. Okay. And again, try that one. Okay. Okay. Let's uncover that eye now and try to cover this eye this time. And we'll just do the same again. Okay. Good. Good. Yeah. Uh-huh. Good. Going, you're doing really well. Good. Yeah. Okay. Nearly there. Keep going. Good job. Okay. We try this last line with this eye. Just give it a go. Uh-huh. Okay. Okay. Try this one again. Okay. Alright. Alright, so it seems as though that we're having a little bit more trouble with your right eye as opposed to your left. Was that sort of similar to the last appointment? Yeah? Alright, just give me 2 seconds. I'm just going to make a note for myself so that I remember. You did a really good job. Next, I'm going to be having a little look at your pupil dilation. Okay, so I have 2 different lights with me here. We're going to be using both. One is a UV style purple light, and with this, I'm going to first check that there is no damage that I can see to the eye. Okay, so we're looking for anything that shouldn't be in there, so any sort of sand, grit, or dirt, and then again, if there are any abrasions to the eye itself. Okay, but your eyes feel fine overall? Good. Okay, just stay nice and still. I'm gonna have a little look at this eye first. And as you say, you don't feel any sort of pain or discomfort, anything like that, no? That's good to hear. Usually if there's something in the eye, we tend to get quite noticeable irritation. Moving on to the other eye here. Again, no issues with this eye now. Healthy. What I'll now do is have a little look at the outer eye as well, the surrounding areas, to make sure it's nice and symmetrical, feeling nice, there's no lumps or bumps that we should be concerned about, okay? So I'm just going to prep. Using an anti-back wipe first, just to keep my hands nice and clean. Obviously, the eye is a very sensitive area. We don't want to be adding unnecessary infections, okay? You doing okay? Good. It's very, very warm, isn't it? I feel very, very lucky to be seeing the back of the heat wave now. Fingers crossed. And I'm going to pop some gloves on as well, okay? Just for that extra layer of protection for you. Okay, there we go. So just stay nice and still. I'm just going to very, very gently have a feel around the eye. Okay. I'm happy with that. No pain? Good. Put these gloves to the side. Alright, so I'm happy with the quality of your eyes. I'm happy with the condition. There seems to be nothing to worry about at all. And you're, again, as you said, not experiencing any pain, so we're all set. Good. Okay. So I'm going to take my next torch here now. This is a nice bright light, and I'm going to be looking in your eyes again, but this time I'm going to be assessing your pupil dilation, okay? So we'll start off eye by eye, and then I'm going to be switching from eye to eye to check that you're dilating and contracting as the light switches, okay? I want to make sure that that dilation is nice and even. So, I'm going to start off with this eye here. Let me know if at any time you need a break, okay? The next eye here. Okay. Good. Okay. There seems to be a little bit of laziness on this eye when it comes to pupil dilation. So as I said, I'm just going to compare the two now, okay? Good. I'll give your eyes a little bit of a rest now. Okay. Better? That's the last of the light examinations I'm going to be performing for you today. We're now going to be doing some periphery testing. So I'm going to be testing your peripheral vision, meaning the space that you can see out of your immediate eye line. So all around this area here. Alright, so we're going to do a few different tests to examine this. I'm first going to ask you to keep your head nice and still for me and just focus in on my nose. Okay, I'm going to be bringing my hands into your field of vision and I simply just want you to tell me when you can see. Okay, ready? Good. 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 Okay. Let's do that again. Good job. Good. 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 Okay, let's go to this eye. And we'll do the same again, keeping your attention on my nose, keeping that head nice and straight. Good. 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 Good, okay. And switching over now. Okay, same again. You're doing really well. Good. Good. Great job. Okay. Next periphery test. I'm going to ask you again to keep your head nice and still and focus in on my nose here. Alright. And I'm going to be putting up a few different numbers. And I just want you to tell me what number you can see without looking at it. Okay, I'll do that with both eyes now. Alright. 5, good. 2, okay. Good. 3, good. 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 Great job. Okay. We're going to do the same, but now eye by eye. So covering your right eye first. Ready? Good. 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 Okay. Alright, and then covering your left eye this time. The same again. Ready? Test. We're going to be doing exactly the same, but this time I'm going to be wiggling either my left, your right, or my right, your left fingers. And I just want you to tell me which side is wiggling, but again, keeping your focus on my nose. So let's do your right and your left. Ready? Good. Good. Okay. and we'll do exactly the same again. Okay? Good. Let me move a little back. Good. Okay. Good job. Good. Good job, okay, and then uncovering and covering the final line. Alright, let's do that again. Good. Okay. Good. Okay. Alright, my lovely rest. Okay, that's the end of the periphery examinations. Your peripheral vision seems really nice and healthy. You seem to be able to see the full parameter nice and clearly. Okay, finally, we're just going to be doing some eye tracking, especially as we saw a little bit of laziness within the pupil dilation for this eye. I want to make sure that the pupil tracking is following the same, so that it's not an actual sort of laziness, it's just maybe the dilation's a little bit different. Okay, so I'm going to be asking you to simply follow my finger with your eyes. So again, keeping that head nice and still, this time just moving your eyes around the room. Okay, ready? Okay, great. Now let's test your depth perception. Okay, so I'm going to be asking you to stare at my finger. Good. And then stare at my nose. And then at the lamp behind me. Good. Okay, let's do that again. At my finger. And then at my nose. And then at the lamp behind me. Back to my finger, back to the lamp, then at my nose, back to the lamp again, and my finger, back at my nose, back at my finger, back at the lamp, back at my finger. Great job. Okay, I'm happy with your eye assessment. Let me just write a couple of notes down here. Dilation on this eye may just be due to maybe some tiredness. Do you stare at screens quite a lot? That can sometimes have an effect, definitely on our light travelling into the eye. We can be a little bit desensitised to it. Okay, so that might be what's occurring right now. But it seems as though, based on your Snellen chart readings, you are in need of a new pair of glasses. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to be doing a lens test with you now, just to assess exactly what prescription that you may need. Okay, so we're going to revert back to the Snellen chart, and I'm going to be using my lenses here. Okay, I think I'm in a nice little fancy case. can see all of my lovely lenses here. I'm going to be using these lenses to assess what your prescription needs to be. And I'm going to be asking you whether a lens makes the image clearer or not. Okay. Okay, and we're going to be starting at your previous prescription. So I'm going to be placing the lenses in front of you like this, and I'm going to ask you whether they're clearer or not as clear. So we're going to be doing one or two. Now you started on a 1.5, that was your most recent prescription. So I'm going to ask you if this is clearer. This is 1.5. So is this one or two? Which do you prefer? One or two? Two? Okay. Okay, so we've got the left eye on a 1.75 prescription. Let me write that down. Okay, starting the left eye now, we're going to continue on. Going to go back to our 1.5. So we've got one or two. Which do you prefer? One or two? Two. Three or four? Three or four? Four. Five or six? Five or six? Again, okay. We've got 5. Or 6. 5.
Okay. Okie dokie, so left eye sitting at a -2.5. So we've had a 0.25 progression on the right eye and a -1 progression on the left eye. Okay.
Alright, so I've written down your prescription, and what I can do for you now is send you over to book a glasses appointment. Yes? Great. You still need to go in for your photograph and your glaucoma testing. So I'll send you off to do that now, and then we'll get you booked in for your glasses appointment. She should be available today. It has been quite busy, but there are still a few slots left, I think. Yeah, so you can get that 25% discount. All right. Great. Do you have any questions for me at all? No? All right then, my lovely. I will leave you to it. Best of luck with your glasses appointments. I hope that you find a new pair that you like. All right. It's been a pleasure. Okay. Bye-bye. How was your eye appointment? Good. I believe that you were just with Sophie, right? Okay. All right. And it went well. Yeah. Yes, you do get the 25% discount if you, book
sort of yellow color.
So we'd call these a medium frame. These are called Barbara Brown. You can see they have a few different colours of brown in them. And then it's exactly the same on the arm as well. We don't have any nice rubber. to show. Special additions, and I've got your measurements.